Hello friends, good afternoon. Today we are going to discuss about the recording techniques which are used in the method study. As you know, select, record, examine, develop, define, install and maintain are the major steps of the flow of the method study, out of which we are going to study recording techniques in detail. And recording techniques can be in the variety of forms. It can be in the forms of graphs, it can be in terms of charts, tables, it can be into graphs and so on. And the recording techniques can also be on a time scale, and those can also be without time scale. Today we are going to study one of the preliminary recording technique, which is called as a flow process chart. At the end of this session, you will be able to draw and apply flow process chart during the method study part of it. The contents of the today's session will be, we will have a small introduction, the significance of a flow process chart, what are the various symbols used for the flow process chart, and how to draw the flow process chart, what are the activities and the construction details of the flow process chart. As you know, the flow process chart is a process which a process chart setting out the sequence of the flow of a product or a procedure by recording all events under review using the appropriate process chart symbols. There are a variety of flow process charts. The first one is material type flow process chart, which is indicating the flow of the material from one place to another place. There is other type called as man type flow process chart, which is indicating the movement of the person from various workstations to the end of the particular process. And the third one, which is called as equipment type flow process chart, which tracks on the movement of the equipment and how the equipment travels from one place to another place. The significance or the importance of the flow process chart is, it is a chart of a flow process chart is a chart of all activities involved in the process, not usually used for the entire assemblies. It is generally used for one component or generally for a single operator. Process chart summarizes the whole process start to end. These are used to compare the existing and the proposed method. We have to draw the flow process chart for the existing method. We have to analyze the flow process chart, reduce the unnecessary movements or unnecessary distance during the particular process. Again, redraw the flow process chart and compare the flow process chart with the initial or start of the process and the proposed or the new method of the process, where you will find that at the end of the proposed method, we will be able to compare and we will be able to find out what is the possible saving in terms of distance and time or the movement of the operator or the equipment. Every detail is understood and the chart of the existing and proposed situation is drawn. Additional information on the operator sequence and the distance traveled per the particular process is also shown over here. There are a variety of standardized flow process symbols which are used while drawing the charts. These symbols are, the first one is operation, which is indicated by a circle. Operation can be a manual operation, it can be a machine operation. It indicates the main step in a process, method or procedure. Usually the part, material or product concerned is modified or changed during the operation. Next symbol is inspection. It is indicated by a square. It is inspection for the quality or check for the quantity. It can be either a quality check or a quantity check. Quality check can be in terms of a variable measurement. It can also be for a attribute measurement. It can be in the form of yes, no, present, absent, okay, not okay, accepted, not accepted, go, no go, or it can be any value by a measuring instrument, or it can just simply give a particular check for either a particular operation is accepted or not accepted. The third symbol is transportation, which is indicated by an arrow, which is indicating the movement of the worker or the material from one place to the another place. It can also indicate the equipment movement from place to place. Temporary storage or delay, which is generally indicated by a capital D of English letter. It indicates a delay in the sequence of events, for example, worker waiting between consecutive operations or any object laid aside temporarily without a record until required. Generally, in the variety of machine shops, we'll observe that a particular job is waiting for a particular process because the machine is already overloaded or the machine is having a constraint. As a result of that, material is piled up near that machine and job is waiting for that particular operation. Therefore, in such cases, it is generally denoted as a temporary storage. Or sometimes, for unforeseen circumstances like electricity failure or machine maintenance or operator absent, there can be a delay for the particular process and therefore the job is only indicated as a D. The job is lying there only for some moment of time. As soon as a particular delay is removed, either machine is having a maintenance which is cleared or electricity starts supply, electric supply starts once again, then probably the machine gets okay and then the job can be processed on that machine where the delay can be further eliminated. The next symbol which is used for the flow process chart is called as a permanent store, which is generally indicated by an inverted triangle. It indicates a controlled storage in which material is received into or issued from a store under some form of authorization or an item is retained for the reference purpose. Generally, there are a variety of stores in the organizations. It can be a raw material storage, it can be a finished storage, or it can be a tool storage, it can be a inspection storage, and so on. A job generally is taken from a raw material storage, processed under a variety of workstations, and then finally given to the FG store, generally called as finished goods stores, where it is further moved for the shipping or dispatch. Any storage activity, either a raw material storage or temporary or the permanent storage in the FG storage, is generally indicated by a permanent storage activity as such. These are the five basic symbols which are used for drawing a process chart. Now, there can be other issues. For example, now you think of a particular combined activity where a operation is going on along with the inspection. And in such cases, we are interested to show both the activities simultaneously. When it is desired to show activities performed at the same time or by the same operator at the same workstation, the symbol for those activities are combined. As a operator is doing some operation at the same time, he is inspecting it also. In this case, the symbol can be combined with inspection and operation, and it looks like this. It is a circle which is drawn in a square. You can have combination of variety of symbols depending upon the combination of the activities. Once we understand the variety of different charts of jar symbols, now we will proceed for the example of each of these operations. For example, a process chart symbol circle is indicated and some examples are shown, like a manual operation driving a node or a machine operation like drilling a hole or a typing process and so on. Transportation, it is a movement by the particular operator, movement by a truck, movement by the hoist or crane, or a man movement from carrying out inventory from one place to another. It can be a messenger which is taking a message from one workstation to another stage. There are some other examples of inspection, a square which is indicating as inspection activity, which is examine material for quality or quantity. It can be the reading the gauge or of the boiler. It is just showing a pressure or some particular indication, or it can be examination of the print form of the information. Delays, material in truck which is waiting for unloading is also indicated as a material in truck or floor, indicating as this. And storage, variety of storages are shown over here. This is a construction where the step by step procedure for the construction is given. Now we have to draw a procedure, we have to draw a chart by following all these steps of the construction. Once these understood, you can, the particular steps are understood, you have to follow the various chart symbols and draw a flow process chart. The flow process chart will look like this. The flow process chart will be indicating the total summary. When the process chart are being made regularly, it is convenient to use in a printed or stainless sheet as shown in the figure. Thank you.